And Ryan Tayobo. Good afternoon to you both. Interesting that we're bringing this about. Again, the problems, challenges facing Philippine agriculture is the lack of supply in some cases, especially now challenged by the El Nino. We have problems with irrigation. Just what is edible landscaping and how does it solve that problem?
Okay, so edible landscaping basically is an approach that merges science of crop production and the art of landscaping. So here, instead of planting ornamental plants, we are planting different vegetables, fruits, herbs, even medicinal plants. So in edible landscaping, we are provided with beautiful landscape as well as food for our family.
Iniisip natin, actually, Stan, I don't know, one familiar country that's actually doing something like this on top of their rooftops because of the lack of available space is Japan.
Yes.
But where are we in that emerging trend?
Well, in terms of planning for land where we can implement landscape, edible landscaping, we can choose even the limited spaces because we have different planting techniques that we can use in order to incorporate vegetable growing in landscaping. Some can rely on hydroponics or SNAP, and the other can also venture on vertical gardening, wherein they can incorporate vegetables in their garden using their walls.
It's a trend. I mean, a lot of people are picking up. Is this something that you recommend to farmers on a large scale, or you can even do this as a household? Because a lot of viewers might be interested if, you know, you have a small space at home and you want to utilize it by making it productive and at the same time beautiful.
And it's actually accessible that way.
Yes, yes. Actually, it is promoted for the household
to provide
them daily food for the family.
Mm-hmm. Well, the main goal of edible landscaping is to provide daily food for our household level. So if you have a garden near to your house, so your food will be accessible anytime during harvesting of these crops.
Just how much are we talking about pag sinabi mo doon? I know that in terms of portions, an individual should have at least 2 servings of vegetables or fruits per day. Pero I can't imagine how that would fit in like a small garden, or probably most people don't even have one.
Well, in terms of meeting the requirement for each family member, so edible landscaping will be limited in that because of your limited spaces, you have the limitation in time in terms of choices of crops and the quality and quantity of our amount of produce. But the goal is to help in meeting this requirement.
Go into the crops then. Ano ba yung kaya?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So we have na itanim.
Okay, so basically we can do container gardening. So here you can plant lettuce or even pechay or even tomatoes and eggplants. So based on the limited space, we are designing your garden based on your site.
Your serious lettuce?
Yes.
Don't you need like a different climate for that?
As of now, we have different varieties of crops that can suit to different climates.
Okay, so let's talk about the landscaping in an urban setting. Let's Philippinize it a bit. Consider the climate, maybe a condo unit where you only have a limited space like a veranda or a terrace perhaps. What types of vegetables can you easily grow if you're an amateur, if you don't have green thumbs, you don't know much about the technology? What can people do now? What are the low-lying fruits?
Okay, you can use our fruit veg like tomatoes, eggplant,
right.
And then we can use pechay.
Okay, pechay is easy to grow.
Yes, it's easy to grow. And in a 1 month period, you can harvest pechay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So those leafy vegetables. And even for lettuces, you can use the hydroponics or even in pots.
Right. What in pots? What about garlic and onion? These are
garlic
everyday
onions,
food needs, cooking needs.
Kaya
for sauté.
Lahat ng ginagamit yung panggisa.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
We can grow in a container. Given that for limited spaces, you have also complexity in growing those crops.
Because a lot of people don't seem to realize the importance of how it can actually help you economically.
Mm-hmm.
How it can help you save, in fact, on your daily food marketing, grocery expenses, when you already have these basic vegetables. Mm-hmm.
Not to mention the options, because some people would really prefer to go organic.
Yes. In terms of planting techniques, you can go organic, and also you can go to the conventional method of growing.
Mm-hmm. But how different is this edible landscaping from the conventional, we're saying, beyond the use of space, beyond... Mm-hmm. It's a question of how, no?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So edible landscaping, like what I said earlier, so instead of using ornamental plants, mm-hmm. we are using edible crops. Mm-hmm. So here, you can have a garden like pinakbet garden. You okay. can have salad garden.
But the squash kasama dyan?
Yes. Okay, so we can have sort of that theme gardens that the younger generation can enjoy.
Okay, but we've been talking about the nutritional value of the project. Now, what about the aesthetic side? What plants go together? I mean, we're talking landscaping anyway.
Okay, mm-hmm. so like what I said, you can do pinakbet garden. So
in terms of colors, huh?
Yes.
So landscaping,
variety.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
So we have varieties of different eggplants, tomatoes. Okay. So the colors, the texture of the different plants can go together.
But
very
isn't squash
nice.
A vine?
Exactly. Yes, and so is the eggplant, isn't it?
No, it's a shrub.
It's a shrub. Okay. Okay.
So for squash, you can have it on the trellis or you can have it on your ground.
Mm-hmm. And also, there are different varieties, species of vegetable crops that can emanate different colors. Mm-hmm. Like in kamote, sweet potato, everyone just know it's just green, violet. Yeah. But now we have light green, reddish color.
So it's really also by design. You're talking about aesthetic.
Yeah.
Kailangan, the aesthetic as if you're really bringing in a designer to plan this. Where do we find them?
Part of the program of edible landscaping is to train the end user on how to design their own edible landscape.
Is this something they can do easily, like on the internet perhaps, research, get some materials and ideas? Do you have like a standard curriculum that's
There's
readily
no standard
available
design for each location, but you can choose what the crops you want to grow. So depending on the meal that you want to prepare, you can choose crops that can fit into your edible landscape. And the design is as simple as just drawing some different shapes that will provide enough space and or requirements for the crop to grow.
It seems easy for people with a lot of space to work with, but for those who don't have enough, I mean, they're really running out of options too, aren't they?
You can move up. And also, for example, for a simple container, you can plant not only one crop. You can combine the different crops that will grow in one container.
Hindi magkalaban-laban yan. But is that the same story when it comes to herbs? Because I know that herbs are also hard to grow. I mean, mapili pa yan pagdating sa, is it going to be outdoors? Is it going to have to be under shade?
Yes. For some crops, it's really hard to grow in your backyard. So we have a list in our training. We have different crops that you can choose from different types of vegetables that can be grown in edible landscaping. But for herbs and spices, there are some that hardy in some areas, and there are some naman na talagang mahirap patubuin.
So people could actually learn this on their own, or get experts from maybe UP Los Baños?
Yes.
The practitioners?
The project is funded by the Department of Agriculture, Bureau of Agricultural Research, and in UPLB, we are the lead team to promote edible landscaping. Actually, we have this project of promoting this technology in the whole Philippines. So we are conducting trainings for the different provinces.
What about households? If they're interested to learn more about edible landscaping, can they just enroll in a short-term course perhaps or get some materials from you?
And even
at a reasonable price.
And is it even online?
As of now, we don't have a whole course on teaching edible landscaping, but we are conducting simple trainings. So they can just ask the Department of Agriculture, Bureau of Agricultural Research on conducting these scheduled researches or schedule the trainings.
Do break down those trainings for us. Ano-ano yung mga components na pwedeng pag-aralan? At immediately, soon after that, they can actually put the theory into practice.
Okay, so part of the training is, syempre, is the discussion about what is edible landscaping and what's the difference between your conventional gardening and edible landscaping. And then we will discuss the components of edible landscaping and then the process. For the components, we have the softscapes, hardscape,
which
paano pagpipili ng halaman, anong hardscape or yung mga materials na gagamitin for edible landscaping. And then we have the process, how to design, how to implement, and how to maintain your garden. So and then after the theoretical part, we have also yung implementation of some selected designs para makita nila
how
kung ano ba talaga yung itsura ng ginawa nila sa papel.
Pero yung ibang tao, syempre sabihin nila, ayoko na ara-ara, gusto ko na talaga magtanim.
Yeah.
In fact, gusto ko na mag-harvest.
Yes.
So, paano yun? Is there anything that makes it even simpler for them?
Well, basically, if you really want to harvest, you need to plant. You need to sow the seed. So, we are teaching the Yes, we have this starter kit developed by our team. So here, it can be guided you to start your own edible landscaping. So here we have the sample seed mix, which are
for different things.
Yes, we have pinakbet garden, herb garden, go grow, glow garden, and salad garden.
Basically, yung bawat isa po kasing starter kit has its own design.
Okay.
So for example, meron tayong apat na garden teams, yung sinasabi ng pinakbet, herb garden, go grow and glow, and salad garden.
And which of the four is easiest to execute? For someone who is lazy, perhaps, or has no time to really maintain and be a farmer. For people in the city who want to get into edible landscaping and not invest so much of their time.
In terms of period of production, we can recommend the salad garden because you can just leafy a vegetable in just 1 month, you can harvest.
Ilang beses dinidiligan yan in one day?
For one day. It will depend on the type of the growing media and the container. If you have a small container, you have to devise a frequent irrigation for the plant. But if you have larger and a good growing media that can hold much more water, it will lessen your work.
And for those who want the challenge of really getting into edible landscaping,
the go grow and the pinakbet garden.
Go grow
and pinakbet. So, and also incorporated in the
kit?
In the kit is yung aming mga primers kung saan we discuss everything about edible landscaping.
Wow.
So about yung aming primer, which will discuss the concept of edible landscaping, and then yung aming hardscapes. So for hardscapes, yung pathwalks, containers, and then softscapes, the list of plants that they can use in edible landscaping, and syempre, yung process. How to design, how to implement, and how to maintain the landscape.
And it's easy because it could be a challenge to creativity, Randy, but they don't even have to follow the rules, but they do have to go with the available ingredients. And you're talking about seeds. The packet comes with one choice.
Yes.
But easily, these are also accessible anywhere.
Yes. Mm-hmm. In any garden store or any agricultural shop, they can buy different varieties of seeds.
Do you have a success story? Say you can cite someone who's used only this much land, say 1 meter by 1 meter, and then he was able to harvest a variety of vegetables from it?
Okay. We had a successful story, a family in Bae, Laguna. So they have this small garden and they planted different crops, and they actually uses are different recyclable materials like old tires, our plastic pot bottles. So here you can really see how they engage their creativity in the production, and they also say that it helped them a lot in saving money for food for their family.
And also there's a school in Los Baños wherein they have their own edible landscape wherein the pupils or the children are the one maintaining the plants.
Mm-hmm. And for those interested, is there a number they can call? Contact you perhaps?
Yes. So for interested people, you can contact us on 049-536-0716, and for other questions, you can also email us at edible_landscaping, and you can also like us on Facebook, Edible Landscaping UPLB, and follow us on Instagram, Edible Landscaping.
There's no website yet.
Yes. Or just Google Edible Landscaping UPLB or Edible Landscaping Philippines, and all of the details, some of the details will come up.
Well, practically, that's art and good health from the field to the plate. Thank you very much, gentlemen. Yes, Brian Apasionado, instructor of UP Los Baños, and also an instructor, Ryan Tayobong. Thank you for your time, gentlemen.
Up next, results of Game 3 of the NBA's Western Conference Finals.
And find out who won in the world's biggest international music show, Sports and Entertainment, when Dateline Philippines Weekend returns.